I create a R&R, one, to hopefully and positively influence some perspectives out there, or at the very least to trigger some food for thought energy. And two, well, let's face it, everybody got a soapbox with their two cents in it, and I'm putting mine on the internet to see where it goes. And speaking of the internet and positivity, which nowadays are two things that you would only see written next to each other in the same sentence if they're immediately followed by a question mark and the words bitch please, I've been noticing a certain behavior amongst a certain species of people that I thought fizzled out because of how corny it was, but snap back into reality and realize it ain't gone nowhere and it's just as prevalent as it's always been. I'm talking, of course, about bitter boys. Recently, I was having a casual conversation where I was informed on a story about a woman who was, I guess, outed going around sleeping with a bunch of married dudes, which is grimy as fuck, but that's besides my point. See, I heard a lot of dudes were going in on this lady, which I guess is the nature of that beast, but they was going like in. They was like threatening her and saying they hope she died and shit like that, which is extra. And what's crazy about it is that a lot of the dudes that was going in on her were the same married dudes that she was hopping. You know what I'm saying? And that is where we're going throw the flag.
That's some bitch ass behavior. Offside, 15-yard line.
These are bitter boys, grown ass dudes that's still in their feelings about whatever female done did them dirty whenever way back when in their life. And now they just throw that energy at damn near any woman they come across. And that's against the code, especially if you was one of these married dudes. You ain't got room to have an attitude, bitch. Takes two to take down. You grimy too. You was creeping on the missus. So what is you acting her for? What? What? Don't tell me you was trying to cuff. Nah, you just bitter boy. And you know where this energy comes from? See, a lot of these dudes wasn't that good with the ladies back in the day, and they get hurt a lot. And I ain't gonna vilify nobody for that, cause you know, I was in that boat when I was young, you know, I'll keep it a buck. But I eventually got over it, and I don't have that problem no more. A lot of these dudes carry that baggage into their 30s, 40s, 50s. And the ones that eventually got married, well, the stink from that baggage was still affecting their minds. See, they thought, keyword thought, that they was gonna be player running game, you know what I'm saying? Cause they got their wife, but then they got their little thing on the side, so they think they in there now. And to them, it's like some weird symbolic form of retrospective revenge against all the girls that burned them before. But Shyamalan twist, turns out she was the one running game on yo punk ass. And that realization has got you so far in your feelings that not even cosmic awareness could find your ass. And while these dudes are throwing their bitter boy temper tantrums, they don't even think about the fact that they got partners that they stepped out on. And she probably left you. Good. Now you ain't got no wife or side piece. And your plans are foiled like Dr. Draken's, and your balls are blue like them too. But the reason this issue really sticks in my crawfish is not out of some sense of pseudo nobility, but really cause our kids are being raised around this energy, bruh. Seriously, bitter boys aren't in just one area of activity. They're all over the place, and they come in various irritating shapes and sizes. Those dudes that was a part of that OnlyFans outrage, you remember that shit? Guys were extra furious that women were doing what they've had the ability to do since the spawn of the human race. Which is stupid for a plethora of reasons, but mainly cause if they're making money doing it, clearly it means that these dudes like it enough to pay for it. So if you want to get mad at somebody, get mad at them. Don't even get mad at them. Let them live. Just stop being a bitter boy. Damn. And these dudes, they be judging people from their imaginary high ground, knowing full well if old girls would throw the onion in their face, they'd be all like, bitter wouldn't be so bad then, would it? Those dudes that were just seething over the sheer announcement of an all-female cast of Ghostbusters, bitter boys. Those dudes that actually got upset at them hashtag waste his time 2016 jokes, bitter boys. Those dudes that got super mad that the female characters in Mortal Kombat 11 had slightly less skimpy outfits and that Tifa's tatas got toned down in the Final Fantasy VII remake. Fucking weirdos and bitter boys. And you know what makes it even more shameful is that they're so transparent. They want women to be interested in them, but they too prideful to work on themselves. And now they think that because they got hurt a few times, females somehow owe them something and shit's just supposed to plop in their lap. And they walk around with that stank ass energy repulsing any estrogen life form that comes near them. So oblivious to their own behavior, not knowing that they're the source of their own misery. Cause a bitter boy mentality more so comes from an internal source than an external one. And y'all gotta start learning to charge shit to the game. Rant conclusion, bitter boys are some bitches. If you a young youth man, don't be like these fools. Work through your issues in a healthy way. Don't hold grudges. If a girl kneecaps your feelings, realize it's not the end of your life and it's not gonna change who you are, you know, unless you allow it to, you know what I'm saying? Also, you could try this thing called talking to women. That's right, talking to them. That's why a lot of bitter boys fail, because they fantasize about females all day, but they don't actually talk to them. And as a result, they don't know not a nat nothing about how they think. You'd be surprised at the amount of women out there, fine women, that just want to have a normal conversation. And that can lead to a plethora of positive possibilities. And be respectful, despite whatever mask of manliness you make macho homeboys are wearing. Respecting a woman does not mean she walks all over you or that you're whipped. The way you treat a woman is really reflective of how you carry yourself as a man. And we seriously need more men out here, bruh. Y'all better stop being bitter and make these ladies your allies, because once you learn to do that, life, so much smoother.